each day that we've been to before have major concerns at this address. There's 67 dogs that live there, and I also have concern for a number of chickens at the address.
The property and our outside of Brisbane is not a traditional residence.
Hey, buddy.
The owners moved here 25 years ago to live an alternative lifestyle. But that's not the RSPCA's concern. They're worried about the living conditions of all the animals here.
Hi, Mrs. Sullivan. This is Simon. Simon was one of our new inspectors. We've got Vicky, our vet, who you've met before. And Tom as well, who you've met before. Okay, we'll just do a walkthrough. Ben, as usual, I'll come up and let you know if there's anything that needs to be done. Okay? Thank you.
This is the fourth time the RSPCA has visited this property.
See this cage here? When we first came out, there was dogs actually living in this size cage. So we did remove off the property a number of dogs because they were kept too closely confined.
But despite RSPCA warnings, the living conditions of the animals are still unacceptable.
We have a look in its enclosure that it's chained to. You can see that there's a lot of carcass material, and it's very, very wet. So there's nowhere for this dog to get anywhere where it's dry, and its water is brown and full of mosquito larvae.
It's the same old story if you've got a large number of dogs.
It's all right.
It's physically impossible for one person to look after
them. That's your decision. Keeping them to your standard and keeping them to my standard is totally different. These are farm dogs.
We are not going to leave these dogs in these conditions. You're going to have to do things to improve the situation and do it fast, because we just can't leave them like this.
On Sydney's northern beaches, a much like family cat
is stuck in a palm tree. Right, that's
you going, pal?
That's enough now, come on. Don't bite his foot!
Show us where he is.
In this house.